Get ready to match the stars. Scoey Mitchell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Dolly Martin. Bill Daly. And Debralee Scott. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
How do you do, John?
Thank you, friends. How do you do?
Hey, good crowd up there.
Yeah, good bud. I was going to strike a pose up there and put my hand in the pocket, you know, the way the male models do in clothing ads, and be very suave. And I started to do this, and the thing is sewn up.
Not sewn up.
Yes, it is.
It is not. Well, cheap tailor never put a pocket in there.
No.
Wait till you try to go to the John.
Oh. Would you please join me in a little brisk applause for our two players, Ted Miller and Sandy Buschinski.
Thank you. Now we want to find out who these people are and where they're from.
Ensign, let's begin with you.
All right, I'm currently stationed down in San Diego with a helicopter squadron. I've been in the Navy about 8 years, and my wife and I are just moving into a condominium.
Into a what?
Into a condominium. Where did you graduate?
University of Texas at Austin.
And you graduated as an ensign?
Yes.
I didn't know they were graduating ensigns there. I thought you had to go to Annapolis to be an ensign.
Oh, got lucky.
You did. All right. Now, Sandy, tell us about you.
Well, I'm single.
All right. That's enough. I don't want to hear anymore. That's all I want to hear.
Okay.
Oh, go ahead.
I'm a bunny.
I want to hear all about it now.
A bunny.
Go all the way.
I live in Sherman Oaks, not to disappoint you.
Sherman Oaks?
Yes, I'm an aspiring dancer.
Yes.
And,
You study and work out as a dancer?
I work out
every day?
Yes.
Good.
And if you believe
that, I...
All right, here on Match Game PM, you'll each have three opportunities to match as many of the dingbats as you possibly can. The one who's done that most often will be the winner at the end of the third round and go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. There we go. A or B?
A.
Henson says A.
A.
Harold is so cheap.
How cheap is he?
He once tried to call blank collect. So cheap, he once tried to call blank collect. Harold is so cheap, he once tried to call blank collect.
The telephone company.
The telephone company. All right. You get yays and boos. May we see what you have, sir?
Dolly, you're so easy to please.
I had to call the operator.
The operator. Didn't come up.
What do you say?
Funny. I was waiting for the light to light, but it didn't light. The operator and the phone company, I guess, are in two different places. Okay.
Are you sure of that?
I suppose so.
Anyway.
Yes.
Cute as a button. Anyway, this is someone we knew and loved to death. He was so fabulous and so wonderful. Jack Benny.
Jack Benny.
Yeah.
He would never accept a collect call.
Well, some of you may be too young to remember that great performer, Jack Benny, but there are those of us who do, and we remember what he was known for. Cheapness.
Speaking of cheapness, look at this lace.
Have a good time with
I
this little devil.
I told her never to try to leave with the tablecloth, but she went right out with it.
I love it.
I said, and I'm having 8 years of an attack from this program, information.
Information.
Which I think is a charming answer.
I think it's wonderful. You look very elegant tonight. Is there something special going on?
No, I guess Ira, our beloved, who I love, Mr. Scotch, our producer. Thank you. But the problem is, I don't have any clothes, and I bought this very expensive pair of Italian shoes. I like to go with no shoes and no socks. The minute I tried to get like Marcel Marceau Gianni, that's what happened.
Right.
Wasn't that a boring story?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yay! Yay for boring!
Yay.
Dolly, Harold is so cheap he once tried to call Blank Collect.
Telephone cutting is a very good answer.
Yes.
I really think, I couldn't think of anything else but himself.
Call himself Collect.
Don't let him turn
hostile.
On you.
Sir, this is the bad one coming. He tried to make an obscene phone call, Collect.
Okay.
But he's got to these shoes.
Tell us about these shoes.
And they have these Italian things
yes,
on them.
Yeah.
But, you know, I mean, I just... I'm...
Right. Oh,
this is covering... It's covering for my bed. I said Howard Hughes.
Howard Hughes.
Howard Hughes. After I showed you my leg?
They were booing your leg.
And you're booing Howard Hughes, too, and he's going to get you. No matter where he is.
He's somewhere out there.
Right. Here we go. Sandy, the used car salesman said that customer was weird. When I showed him the car, he didn't kick the tires. He blanked them. The used car salesman said that customer was weird. When I showed him the car, he didn't kick the tires, he blanked them.
But the answer I had didn't have an ED on the end of it. He it them. I was going to say he blew them.
He blew them. Well, that's a past tense. That's like an ED ending. All right, Scoey.
I'm frightened, Uncle Jane.
It's
I'm
all right.
Frightened.
I'll hold your hand. Everything's going to be all right.
I just got so emotional when she said that what she said,
yeah,
you know?
Yeah, right, right.
Just trying to compose myself.
Be still my heart.
Yes,
yes, of course.
Banged, if you know what I mean.
Right. All right.
No, no. You said weird, right?
Weird.
Tried to dance with them.
Tried to dance with the tire.
No, I don't
that's
like
weird.
That, huh?
Well, you don't
I'm
know weird. That is
I
weird.
I don't care.
Kissed them. He was Italian.
Right. Good.
I
did.
Oh, thank you.
The tire kisser. Alfredo the tire kisser. Customer was weird. When I showed him the car, he didn't kick the tires. He... blew
you know,
them, according to her.
I used to be a bunny, you know, once.
Did you? Were you a bunny?
In England.
No kidding.
Bunny. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, right. Yes.
Got a reputation.
Anyway, that has nothing to do with my answer, which is terrible.
What
he
is it?
He pricked it with a nail.
He didn't kick the
what
tires.
Did she say?
He pricked them with a nail.
He did.
What did you say?
He was weird.
Just drove a nail right into them.
That's what he did.
All right, Bill.
I know this is going to make me look bad, but I said blue. I'm sorry.
Aha! The truth is, friends,
yes.
Bill Daly used to be a bunny also.
I was a dumb bunny.
That customer was weird. When I showed him the car, he didn't kick the tires. He blew them or blanked them.
Blue is like putting air. I said sucked them.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, taking the air out.
Right. Yeah. One is putting the air in, and the other is taking the air out. All right. We have 1-0
right
as a score here. And we got a little commercial for you. Here we go to round 2. Now, since Sandy is ahead, she'll go first.
A for Amy.
A for what?
Amy.
Amy. Who's Amy?
Never mind.
Oh.
You know who Amy is.
When the Martian scientist pointed his giant telescope to Earth, he made a startling discovery. There's no intelligent life in blank. There you are, sir. Okay. When the Martian scientist pointed his giant telescope to Earth, or toward Earth, he made a startling discovery. There's no intelligent life in blank.
Los Angeles.
In Los Angeles?
Now,
what she means is only on this stage. All right, Scoey.
Every time I thought of something, I said, I don't want to offend the folks down there, you know. So I said Alaska.
Alaska. This show goes to Alaska.
Yeah,
right.
Now you tell me.
Now they're going to send more snow.
Just
and...
a little joke, Alaska.
We love you, Alaska.
Maybe they won't catch it.
What do you
got? I think she's cute as a button, and I think she's very smart and perceptive and intelligent herself. And I said all of Los Angeles, including Beverly Hills and the Dreaded Valley.
All right.
What do you mean, Dreaded Valley? I live in the valley. That's what I mean, baby. Dreaded. It's a nice place.
Really?
So what if we get mudslides every once in a while?
I don't want to eat with these patients anymore. I want to have my dinner in the room on a tray.
We'll give you a tray. You can sit in bed and eat, sit up
Thank
and eat
you,
your
doctor.
Yes.
I said, which I thought was the correct answer, Washington, D.C.
Which is the next one? I must say, you've made the patient feel much better. He made a startling discovery. There's no intelligent life in... Go.
Washington.
Washington. All right. Debralee.
Thank you.
Show us your answer, Bill.
No, he doesn't write.
No, because I was the only one to match the last
now,
person.
This.
Go.
That's very rare.
Thank you.
Hollywood.
Hollywood.
That's Los Angeles.
All right. Ted?
One nice guy.
Bill's answer was Oxnard, in case you're interested.
What is Bofina?
Howdy Doody said to the puppet psychiatrist. Howdy Doody speaking to a puppet psychiatrist.
Gotcha.
Doc, he says, I must be self-destructive, key phrase. You see, I've fallen in love with a blank. I understand.
Now I'm going to have to.
Howdy Doody said to the puppet psychiatrist, Doc, I must be self-destructive. You see, I've fallen in love with a blank.
Termite.
Yay! Termite is very good. Great answer.
Very good answer. I said with a buzzsaw.
Buzzsaw is another good one. Termite buzzsaw is excellent.
A axe.
Axe, another good one there. Yeah.
Jamumi. Hello, dear.
As a member of the Coast Guard Auxiliary, I take pride in joining the Navy and a termite named Tilly.
A termite named Tilly. 3-1 the score. Go.
Isn't that a great answer? That's
yes.
A great answer.
Excellent.
I didn't have it, though.
What did
Fire.
You have? Fire is another good answer.
Ooh.
All right, Bill.
Stand by for another boo. A lumberjack.
A lumberjack.
You boo me and you cheer him.
Well, you got your boos already.
Yeah. Debralee.
I hate the six sheet. But that's my little overbite.
Yes, I love your overbite.
Thank you.
I like
and
your
you should know.
I said beaver.
Beaver. All right, let's go to the third and last round. Sandy,
I'm
your head, you'll
winner.
Go first. A or B? A?
Please.
All right. Scoey, Charles, and Dolly are the only three who played.
Oh, dear.
Harvey the artist thought that he himself was a work of art. That's why he blanked himself. Here we go. Harvey the artist thought that he himself was a work of art, and that's why he blanked himself.
Framed?
Framed is a good response. Framed is one of the good choices there.
It certainly was.
You may have one, too.
I said painted.
He painted himself. All right, Charles.
It's a pleasure to match that pretty blonde bunny. Hi, sweetheart. I go to the Playboy Club in Houston where I live. I said frame.
Atta boy. Walter, Sandy. What do you say?
Framed.
You said it. All right, you got five.
Thanks for Debralee.
Now, Ted, that means you need 4 to tie and 5 to win. King Arthur said, "I don't like that Sultan. He moved into the castle next door and turned it into a used blank lot."
Oh, wait, hold on.
Here we go, Ted.
Wait, we have a try and something else.
King Arthur said, "I don't like that Sultan. He moved into the castle next door and turned it into a used blank lot."
Flying carpet.
Oh, I was worried.
Hey, let's hold it down, huh?
That's a very good answer.
You tell him, fat lady.
No, there's one superb answer here. That was not it. Let's see if Scoey has it.
Rug.
What's the superb answer?
Tell you when we get to it.
All right.
And if we don't get to it, I'll reveal it.
Harem.
To a used harem. Interesting. Now you've got to match the others to stay in the game. And Ted is looking for the answer, rug or flying carpet or a thing. The thing the writers were looking for in this, King Arthur said, "I don't like that Sultan. He moved in the castle next door and turned it into a used camel lot."
Now you
got to
play after that.
Now you got
to
play after that.
Why you get food on this lot?
Now, yes.
Woman lot.
Woman lot. Yeah, terrific.
Well, I don't know.
All right, Sandy, when's the game?
I got chariot.
Yeah. Chariot.
What? Chariot.
Yeah.
Gas lot.
Chariot.
Some prizes for you, Ted. Good luck to you in your career. We got him. While we're spinning him off, we're going to spin a message for America. Here we go.
Yes.
Sandy's going to have a go at the big money. She could win over $20,000 here. Let's see if it happens. We polled a studio audience, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Ross. $500 for matching the most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Three of the six stars can assist.
Debralee.
Diane.
Yay!
Diana Ross.
Diana.
Charles.
Diana.
A great, marvelous woman who does some of Brett's clothes, including the lovely ensemble she's wearing today. The great fashion designer, Miss Betsy Ross.
Right, that's two.
Bill.
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 What?
Herb Ross. Who is that?
Just
Herb Ross.
Say it.
Okay, Herb Ross.
Herb Ross. Whoever that is. So you want Herb Ross, Diana Ross, or Betsy Ross? One of those? You want Betsy Ross. All right, let's see if Betsy Ross is on the $100 response. Catherine Ross is there. May we see the next one, please? Betsy Ross. All right.
I bet it's Herb.
Now, who's going to be on top?
Herb. Let me Herb.
Go.
Diana.
All right, now you got $250. Means the least you'll play for is $2,500. But one more audience match. Let's see how you do with that. Blank of Thieves.
Ooh, Dan.
All right.
Okay, come on, honey.
Yeah. Okay, Brett.
Dan.
Yeah.
There's one. Dan of Thieves.
Debralee.
Me, huh?
Huh?
Ooh.
Band.
Yeah. Right.
Band.
Band.
All right, so you have a den of thieves and a band of thieves.
Charles?
What are you doing down there, you fool?
Charles, have you got one?
Gang of thieves.
Gang of thieves, den of thieves, and band of thieves. You want one of those? Maybe you got one of your own.
God, I don't. Dan.
You want a den of thieves? All right, let's take a look at the $100 response and see if Den of Thieves is there. Go. House of Thieves is there.
Sure.
Den of Thieves may be under the next one. Slide that one, if you please. Band of Thieves is there. I think you got the Den of Thieves. Here we go. Yes, you have. All right. Now you've got $250 and $500 means the least you'll play for is $7,500. However, you're going to spin the wheel, and if it lands on a double, you play for $15,000. So good luck to you. We'll all root for a double. Here we go.
Yes, go, baby. Double. Go. Come on, baby. Come on.
Here we go. Dozen blank. No help, please. Dozen blank. D-O-Z-E-N. Dozen blank. All right, give us the answer that Brett has on the card. If you do that, you get $15,000.
I know, it's a dozen roses.
A dozen roses.
I'll never take anyone's advice again. As long as I live, I had eggs and I changed it. Oh, I'm furious. I should have followed my first instinct. I wish I were dead.
Oh. You wrote roses and you changed it to eggs.
Yes, there were two choices, and I should have.
Well, listen,
there
it's not a total loss. You have a total of $750. Congratulations. Oh, thank you for being here. And now this message for America. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next week for Match Game PM. Thank you all. Goodbye.
Extra car wax, extra polymers and silicones make it extra long-lasting. Extra brilliant, extra easy. Turtle extra car wax in liquid and soft paste. And a toolkit. And when you've got anything that sticks or squeaks, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it with WD-40. And a tray and Clorox to breath deodorant. Helps your mouth zone freshening power, eliminate bad breath. Costs a little more, but it's worth it. Clorox, the breath deodorant. Speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.